Let's set up some of the key details of your new team. We'll start with an easy one. What name would you like to give the team? Is critical, so we need to sign a primary sponsor. Our primary sponsor will pay a signing bonus to the team up front. This is vital to cover the early investments we need to make. They will also provide valuable weekly income for us. Each sponsor has a goal that they want the team to achieve. If we hit that goal, the sponsor will pay us an additional goal bonus. Fantastic. Now we've got a budget to work with. Our car won't be going anywhere fast without a power unit. So let's sign a power unit supplier now. We need both performance and durability from our power unit, but we also need to balance the books. We're going to have a lot of other areas to invest our cash into. We almost have all the key partners for our team now, but we still need a teammate for you. These are the drivers available to be your first teammate. They all have their own strengths and weaknesses, so consider everything when deciding who to hire. Drivers earn acclaim based on their performances. When a driver earns enough acclaim, they will level up. The higher a driver's level, the more acclaim they will earn for their current team. And remember, the faster the team levels up, the faster our income will increase. The higher a driver's experience, the more resource points are earned to spend on vehicle upgrades. Racecraft is the driver's skill to effectively complete overtakes when opportunities arise. Awareness shows the driver's ability to avoid errors and incidents. Pace describes the driver's ability to set competitive lap times. Rating is a summary of the driver's overall skill level. Like we can't afford this power unit supplier and teammate. Let's go back into one of those and sign someone cheaper, or try and find a sponsor who pays more up front to offset the cost. Some sponsors offer a larger signing bonus up front. Some offer more weekly income. The better we perform, the more our level will go up as the team gains more acclaim. Doing this will increase the income from our sponsors. Looks like we can afford this power unit supplier and teammate. Go ahead and confirm if you're happy. Let's select or edit the livery we'll be running this season. We can add more sponsors to the car as we sign them throughout the year. And don't worry, we can edit our look at any time from HQ. Now we need a badge for our team branding. Select an existing badge, edit it, or create one from scratch. least, we need to pick team colours for the rest of our branding. You'll see these colours throughout HQ. Great, that's everything we need. You can go back and edit anything we've done so far, and we'll come back here at the start of each season. But if you're ready to go, hit advance to head to Team HQ, and we can start our push to the top of Formula One.
Okay, we're live in 5, 4, 3.
Hello, folks, and welcome to the HQ of Formula One's newest team. We've been invited backstage to gain an exclusive insight into what could be one of the most exciting entries in the sport for many years. Now, we've seen a number of new teams enter the sport over the last decade, amongst their number Manor, Caterham, HRT, and of course, Haas. And while some have proved to be successful, others have morphed into different teams, and some have disappeared completely. What marks this team out, though, as being something different is that its owner is also its driver. Now, there's a rich history of that in Formula One too. So Jack Brabham, John Surtees, Graham Hill, and Bruce McLaren all drove their own cars in the sport, but it has become increasingly rare in recent years. What's very special about this team, though, is that while the team itself is new to Formula One, so too is its driver and owner. Whatever happens this season, you've already made the history books. Tell me, do you feel up to the mammoth task of both managing and driving for a Formula One team? Every team needs two drivers, but what was it that drew you to your teammates? No one aims to finish bottom of the table. Who's the team you're aiming to beat? How are you expecting the car to feel out on track? The other teams now have years of experience, both on and off the track. How are you planning to catch up to them? Overtaking is a key part of this sport. How have you ensured that your car can take advantage of each opportunity? And finally, which of your new departments are you most proud of? Well, that's about all we've got time for here. We will see how this fledgling team fares in its first Grand Prix.
Okay, great. Thank you. That's a wrap.
Great interview, boss. You nailed exactly what the team's been working on. When you've got time, check the R&D tree to see our current progress and where we think there's room for more. And while you're at it, why not take a stroll around HQ and check on how the team's doing? It's important to use the time between races to the fullest extent, and that's where these activities come in. Manage everyone's time as efficiently as possible to maximize the team's performance. This is where you can view our current facilities and the effects they're having on the business. You can also invest some of our cash into upgrades for these facilities. Hey boss, I think we could better manage our time by organizing some team activities. Head to the activity screen to see what we have available.
Hey boss, this is Jeff. Just wanted to say thanks for trusting me as your race engineer. I won't let you down. The car is ready to go, but it's brand new of course, so there may be a few issues here and there. We'll be keeping a close eye on all the data.
In the unforgiving world of Formula One, free practice...
I know it's tempting to focus entirely on the race, but we should put a bit of time aside to run the qualifying sim program. Try to run it before the end of FP3 if you can. Okay, this is a quali sim. We've estimated the times our closest rivals will be doing, so that's what we need to beat. program complete. These results will do, although you could definitely do better. Consider giving it another shot. Best lap so far is a 1:25.4. Try to nail as many corner gates as you can. The faster you get through each corner, the higher the score. DRS zone is coming up. Get ready to open it. Distance is on your MFD. Approaching the DRS zone, watch your MFD for the activation point. Looking good, now let's try for purple. You'll get a bonus for consistency if you can chain good corners together. Great stuff, you've pretty much nailed this circuit. This is a really strong foundation to build from over the weekend. concrete and a job well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can talk you through the numbers.
It's time to remind ourselves of our top three, who are
White,
Bottas,
and Lewis Hamilton.
If you want to know specific information or make certain changes to the car during a pit stop, you can tell me what you want over the radio. Press and... This test is all about tyre management. Try to control the slip through each corner and take extra care putting the power down at the apex. Pace is good, but tyre wear that lap was quite severe. This is the final lap of the program. That's the program complete. Our best lap so far is a 1:28.2. Testing fuel management here, so try to lift and coast going into the corners. Don't be too aggressive on the power, but remember, you still have to beat the minimum lap time. You weren't quite good enough that lap. Try again. was no good. We need you to improve on that. Okay, test over, but I'm afraid we didn't get... Car repairs have set us back a little. This is the ERS management test. Hit the target time whilst managing your battery charge. The more efficiently you use energy throughout the lap, the higher you will score. Use your overtake button for maximum power, but remember, that will drain energy rapidly. Using too much energy. The overtake button gives you maximum power, but it also drains energy quickly. Use it sparingly. Gate test complete, and that was a very good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that.
And with all the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Albon, Verstappen.